Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Now today we are going to see chroma removal with Primate Care in Nuke. So here first we will remove chroma. After this we will compose this shot in Nuke. So here I have imported our footage and also I have imported our background image here. So easily you can see here. So first we have to correct our footage pixel aspect ratio, because this footage has pixel aspect ratio 1.5. So how we can correct? So just double click here in footage, then come here in format, then click here, then just simply click on edit here. So just give a name, so any name you can give. So this is your actually footage frame size and this is pixel aspect ratio. So just here we have to type 1.5 here. Just press OK here. So now you can see here. Okay, so here just first I have corrected our pixel aspect ratio. Now after this, just I am going to start our chroma removal here, or just like a keying here. So I have selected this footage here and just press tab button and just type primate here. So by default actually it attached from our this foreground, and this is our actually background. So temporary, if you want to check your composting, then you can use this one. Okay, so first in primate we have to select our color, which color you want to remove here. So in operation, if you will see this smart select BG color, so this is actually automatic check here. Okay, so direct just you have to select your color here, which color you want to remove. So again just hold control and just click here. So on any pixel you can select and click. So I have selected this one. Now after this, just we have to press A means alpha channel, because here we have to create our solid matte here. So now here you will see this is white means 100% opaque, black means 100% transparent, and gray means just like a semi transparent. Okay, so we have to create pure black and white matte here. So after selecting our color pixels here, then in operations we have to select clean background for removing these pixels and just clean foreground. So if any problem in our foreground or here white matte here, so you can just correct with the help of these two options. So first just I am going to clean over this background, because here this one we have to create pure black here. Then simply just click here, clean background noise means BG noise. So then click and just simple hold control and just click. So you can select pixels, and if you will hold control and shift, so you can select multiple pixels at a time here. So like this easily we can remove. Now support temporary, if you want to check your composting, so now again press A here. So if you want you can use this one background, so just connect it here. And so now you can see, then select this one and press T and just you can adjust this background. Okay, like this. So this is actually your temporary composting, but no one is using this background here. Okay, so now again just unplug from here. So if you want you can use it for just temporary composting. Now here just I am going to see our next option, which is our just garbage mat. Okay, so if you have garbage mat like this, so you can create a roto shape, then you can use it from here or from here also. But in primate, if you will see, primate has already a garbage shape here. So if you want to check, you can check it here. So if you will double click here in primate, so you can see easily this bounding box. Actually this is as a garbage mat here. So if you want to remove this one, so you can adjust this box here like this. Okay, so like this, if you want you can adjust it. Actually this will also just like a crop your footage if you will just place like this here. Okay, so by default in primate this is inbuilt, so if you want you can adjust it here. So maybe this is looking good here. So like this, if you want you can adjust it here, maybe this one. So again I am not going to use this area here, so just we will create a separate roto node here. So now how we can just adjust all these things here. So remaining parameter just refining our mat here. Okay, so main just important parameter here, which is our clean background and just clean foreground here. So now just after the just I am going to just explain how we can use our this garbage mat and how we can remove all these extra other which is our garbage here. Okay, so now just create a roto node here. So just press O here and just little bit connected here temporary, because from here easily we can see. So now press one here, so you can see here. So easily, so I think both sides just we have to remove this one also, and this one also we have to remove. So what I am going to do here, so just I am going to just cover only our character here. So now I have selected this one and just create any shape, whatever shape required. So now after this we have to animate this garbage shape or roto shape according to our character movements. Okay, so now just again animate this one and just adjust, select all and just adjust according to just character movements. So maybe if this marker is coming, then first if you want you can remove this marker also. So I will explain how we can remove this marker, okay, but here just I am going to ignore this one. Okay, so I think this is looking good here. So now after this, how we can use, just select this one and press one here. So what we can do, if you want you can just plug here, which is our just mask input here. So if you want you can also plug it here. So just take this one and just connect it here. After this, just come here in primate here, double click here, then in mask option just click here none and just select RGB a dot alpha here. So now you can see here. So again if you will check in alpha, so you will get only this one area. So remaining value just we will adjust it here. So if you want you can adjust it with the help of again this one, clean background noise, and just hold control and just adjust these pixels here. Okay, so now again if you will come here in RGB mode, so you will see. Okay, even if you want you can also plug this mask just after our this footage here. So if you want you unplug from here and just connect it here, so result is same. Okay, so wherever you want you can use this one, even you can also use after this one. So I think if you will press A here, I think this is looking good here. So now after this, suppose if you want to compose your shot on any background, then you can compose. So here just I am going to compose this shot on our this like a background. So first we have to reformat our this background, then click here and just take whatever you have just created here, which is our edited. Okay, so according to our footage. So now I have taken this one, and if you want after this you can direct compose your primate or put on our any background, because by default primate is also just pre-multiplied by alpha, and also it's applying some spill suppressor here. So by default actually it's applying here. So if you want you can compose on any sort. So just take a merge node, press M, and just this will be our background and this will be our foreground. Now just select this one and press one here. So now you can see here, so this is our composite shot here. So I think this is looking good. And if you want a little bit adjust your edges here, then after this if you want to you can just press tab and type just little bit edge blur here, and remaining value you can adjust according to your requirement. I think this is looking good here, I think. But here I am not going to use a primate output direct as a foreground here. Just first we will create a solid mat here. After this we will use this mat and we will just remove our chroma here. So suppose here if you want to remove marker here, so just little bit check it here. So just press one here and just little bit come here and suppose here. So if you want to remove your marker, then just take a roto node and just manually cover this one. So just I have taken here this one roto node. So you can see here, so just connect after this here like this, and just I have selected this one and press one here, double click here, so you will see. So just simply just basic just shapes I have created and I have covered here like this. And after this just we have to put a marker removal node here. So I have selected this one, press tab button, type marker removal. So this one marker removal, now you can see here. So I think there is no any marker. So if you want, so like this you can first remove your marker, after this you can remove your chroma. Okay, so like this easily you can see, I think there is no any marker. So after this if you want you can use this one here, so you can connect it here. Then if you will just select this one and press one here, so there will be no any marker. Okay, so like this if you want you can also first remove your marker, then you can just like remove your green background here. So again select this, press A here. So again I think this is looking good here. So whatever procedure you want, you can use it. So here I have removed our just like a marker also. So now just finally I am going to just create our final mat, then we will compose this sort on our this background finally, because here we have to also track this sort, because here if you will notice camera is moving here. Okay, so how we can do all corrections here. So now what I am going to do here, take output from primer, so just remove all these values here maybe and delete and delete. So now select one, now press A here, so easily you can see. So this is our actually matte here. So I am not going to use here as a the RGBA, so just as a alpha I am going to use it. So now again first just take a copy node, so just press tab, just type copy. So this copy, so will B means this will be our just original green background, A means this will be our this final mat. Okay, so maybe if you want you can correct it here just like this. Then after this just we have to use our pre-mult here, then press tab and just type pre-mult here. Now just select this one and press 1 here. Now again if you will press 1, so you will get this thing. So just you have to extract our character, and you can also see our some green lines here, because here there is no any spill suppressor applied here. Okay, so just manually we have to remove all these green pixels here. Okay, so now again after this just little bit press tab button and just type edge blur. So if you want a little bit smooth edges and according to requirement you can type it here. Now how we can remove all these just like a green pixels, or you can say our just like spills here. So after this footage just we have to use our hue correct node here. So maybe just little bit press tab and type hue correct this one and just connect it here. Now just I'm going to remove this green pixels here. So again come here in green suppressor, so if you want to just select, so just hold control and just maybe check your pixels, maybe this one. So now you can see here, so just I have selected this one and just move it here. Now just remove here, so if you want you can just remove like this. So here just I have removed our just like a green just like spills here. Now again if you want to compose your sort, then you can compose it here, and remaining if any needed you can also use another hue correct, and you can also adjust some other green pixels if anything is coming here. Okay, so if anything is coming like here if you want, so you can again take, so press tab, just again type hue correct it, and just if you want to adjust then again green suppressor here, so just click. Even if you want you can again select, so this one, so hold control and just select this. So now you can see. Okay, so actually just like a select pixel and just you can remove it here. So now finally just I'm going to compose this sort on our this background here. So again take a merge node, so press M, this will be our background and this will be our foreground here. Now again select this one and press 1 here. So now you can see here, I think this is looking good here. Then little bit if you want to adjust some this background, maybe color, maybe gain, all these things, then you can adjust. So just a little bit, first just use defocus, so press tab, just type defocus here and just maybe define some values here maybe. So now finally what we have to do, so finally just we have to track our this sort, this one, and just we have to apply this tracking data onto our top of our this just like background here. Okay, so how we can do all these things, so again press tab, just type a tracker this one and just connect it here. Now come on first frame, double click here. Now just create a tracker here, so just I'm going to create it here, so just click and just create. So here I have tracked our sort here, then just we have to create our just like a match move data here. So just double click here, then I come here in export, just click on transform match move and just create a node, create, then finally just connect this match move node after all these reformat values. Okay, so if you want you can connect it here like this, just let me adjust it here. Just clear all these value here. So now you can see your background movements according to your just footage motion. So now actually it's shifting because it's applying some match move data here. So before this transform and after this defocus, just press T for transform and just adjust footage. So after this, if you want to just a little bit crop your bounding box, then you can crop or just use reformat. So just take this final merger here, after this press tab, just type crop it here, then finally just simply click on reformat. Now just adjust this little bit of background here, so just transform and just adjust it here. Now you can see here, I think this is looking good here. So now just a little bit come and check it here. So now press H. Now you can see here. So here I think this is looking good here. Okay, so remaining value you can adjust according to your requirement. So after adjusting all these value, you will get this result here. So if you like this video, please watch, share, comment and subscribe my channel if you are still not subscribed my channel.